Okay, I will Messi 5360. I will walk you over assignment 3, which is developing a query with Business Explorer Query Designer. Okay, so in order to get in there, I start, I go to all programs, I go to Business Explorer, and I do not go here, but I go to Query Designer and do not enter the 3.x version. This is older version. If you have this, then you have to install your recent SAP client along with the patch. Okay, so I go to Query Designer and then I log in. I log in using my own ID and password. You log in using your own ID and password. Okay. Okay, so now what happens is I get into info provider, right? Then I open query. No, not sorry, I don't open query. I do new query, right? Yes, I click on info provider, then I click on new query, and then I go to find. Okay, in the find, I click on both search description and technical name, and I type in MU 0R1000. Okay, I find. So I see bike company reporting 00 and I open that. So here is my query designer page. So what do I have to do now? I have to define a restriction for my query. The query should evaluate only data from the calendar year 2007 and only data for the country United States. So click on the filter tab at the bottom of the middle page. Okay, at the bottom of the middle pane, drag and drop both calendar year and country so they appear under characteristic restrictions. Okay, so I have to drag and drop both calendar year and country. So where is my calendar year? Time. Okay, so this is my calendar year, and then I have country that should be within. Cells. So I drag and drop calendar year and country within characteristic restrictions. Okay, now what do I have to do? I am in filter and I have done that. So double click on calendar year to open select values for calendar year. So I double click on calendar year and I can see the values. So what I do is I go to single values. Okay, and I choose 2007. Okay, and then I say okay. Okay, similarly, I double click on the country. I see all the values. I go to single values and I have to choose United States. So I choose United States and I say okay. Okay. Then I have done that. Now filtered values should appear under respective characteristics. Is it appearing? Oh, I think I have to, no, I have to, let me see. I have to go to single values. I choose United States. Oh, I have to keep it, bring it here. Sorry, I made a mistake. Now I click on this, so it was not done before. I double click, I go to single values, I chose 2007, I bring it on the other side, and then I say okay, and then it shows. Okay, now this is correct. Okay, use the save as function to save your query to your favorites folder setting, both the description and the technical name. Okay, so I choose the save as this is save query. No, I cannot do save query. Remember, I have to do save as. I cannot do save query. Please don't do save query. So I do save as, and in my favorites, and in the description, I have to save it as and root is MU50, okay, and then I do R1000, okay, then NNN is my login ID, SAP login ID, and then Q1_sales, okay. Okay, and the technical name is also the same, right? So my technical name is also the same, so I do MU50, then R1000, my login ID 000, you put in your login ID Q1_SALES, sorry, SALES, oh, caps lock is on now, SALES. What's happening to my caps lock? I take it off. Oh, okay, so it would be that way then. Caps lock on or off, it is going to be in caps. That's what is happening to me. An object already exists with the technical name. Choose a different name. Okay, I put another zero, then what else? Save. Okay, switch to the rows and columns view. Display the key figures. Okay, I have the key figures, revenue of by company and discount by company and material by company in the rows. Okay. So I have to display in the rows, define distribution channel as a free characteristic. So distribution channel, where is distribution channel? I drag and drop distribution channel to free characteristics. Okay, let me do the other one first then. Revenue goes to row. Okay, what else goes to the row? Revenue, it says display the key figures, revenue and discount in the column. Sorry, so revenue and discount in the columns. So I take revenue in the columns and discount in the columns, and then I take sales organization and material in the rows. Sales organization, copy, paste. Okay, sales organization and material. And material by company in the rows. Sales organization and material by company in the rows. Revenue and discount in the columns and distribution channel in the free characteristics. Okay, so distribution channel, drag and drop is not working, so let me try this. Distribution channel in the free characteristics. Okay, so I've done that. Now I have to define a calculated local key figure as a formula with the name and description of percentage discount, which is calculated based on the formula discount by revenue multiplied by 100. So to do that, right click on key figures in the column pane. Okay, then I do new formula. Okay, now I need to change the description to percentage discount, so I'll do that, percentage discount, and then I click on edit. Okay, now the change formula dialog box would appear. To create the formula, click on the plus next to key figures. Okay, it's already there. To expand that, double click on discount. I double click on discount, okay, and then I use divided by, and then I click on revenue. Okay, so then I use multiplication, and then I do 100. So it appears as discount by revenue multiplied by 100. Okay, and then I say okay. So it shows under key figures within columns. Okay, now define an exception one with the alert level. Define an exception one with the alert level critical 3 for places where discount is higher than 8.6. Okay, so what do I do now? Exception tab, where is my exception tab? This is my exception tab. I click on that. Here it is. Okay, now right click on exceptions at the top of the pane. Right click on, okay, below here, in the here it's not work. Okay, it's working. So you click on that as a new exception. Okay, now exception one appears. Okay, so I click on here so that it appears on the properties pane, and then I click on edit. Okay, the change exception dialog box is open now, so click on the new button. Where is new? New, and then the alert level operator and value fields will become active. Okay, enter then. Okay, for alert level I entered critical 3. Okay, operator is greater than and the value is 8.6. Okay, and then I transfer, and then I say okay. Okay, now to apply the exception only to the key figure percentage discount, make sure exception one is highlighted. Okay, and its properties appear in the properties pane. Yes, it does. Click on the definition tab, okay, and then click on the drop down list for the key figures. Okay, and select percentage discount for available options. Okay, Now, I save and execute the query using BEX analyzer. So I save. I have already saved it with the name before, so I can just now save the query, and it says contents error. Element is not correct. Element structure is not defined. Actually, there is something called structure here. I don't know where from it came. You won't have it. I just made some mistake here. Let me just remove that structure. Okay. Now I think it should be okay. Rows, exceptions. You should not have it. I just got it from somewhere. Okay. And then I save. Now it saved successfully. And now this is the execute button. I execute the icon. So it's asking me for my ID and password, and I log in using my ID and password. Pop-up blocker. Okay, so I go to options, allow pop-ups. Okay, now I go back, I execute it again. It worked fine now, and see the exception when it was percentage discount was more than 8.6, it has been shown as an exception. Okay. Take a screenshot of your query showing an exception. So I take a screenshot of this and I come here and I paste that. Okay. Rows, exception, definition. No, I want the percentage discount only. Maybe it didn't get saved. Let me save it again. Save query. And then I let me run the query again, okay? Because I have a feeling it has not done properly. So let me run it again. Yeah, this is the right one. The last page was wrong. It is showing the exception. So now I get rid of this and I paste the right one. Okay, this is the right one. Sorry, the last time it wasn't good. Print screen, and I come and I paste here. This is my correct answer. Okay. My problem was this percentage discount under key figures did not get saved. So I go back. Okay. Now display the information about the executed query to display all applied filters. So click the information. Not from here, I believe. I have to go back to here and then I click information. Okay. A separate window will open. Applied filters will show in the top right corner. So these are the filters, 2007 and US United States. Okay, take a screenshot of this, print screen, and then I paste it here. That's my second one. Okay, it went to the top. So let me just do this. This is my first one, and then I have to now I cannot. This is my second one, second printout. Okay, and then my third one would be modify the filter criteria so only materials MB 1, 2, 1, 3, and 1, 4 are displayed. Okay, so right click on the filter link in the top right corner of your screen. slow. Click on the filter screen. I think I need this. Okay, I close. Okay, I need on the filter screen on the top right corner of your screen. Okay, filter here. So difficult to see this. Okay, I click there. A filter area will appear. Okay, and there from here, material by company, show all values. Choose edit. Okay, I chose edit, and then I'm selecting the values for material by company, which is MU0 MATRL. I have to do what? I have to do MB0012. MB0012 add MB0013 and 14. I add. Okay? And I say okay. And then I get the answers for these two different types of bags, 1, 2, 1, 3 and 1, 4. Now I can take a screenshot of the filtered query results, and I'm done with my assignment. Okay. Okay, so this is my key then. And that is it.